Hey guys, in this video, we're going to give you some tips and tricks all around ankle mobility. And in the first place, why is ankle mobility so important and so crucial for CrossFit performance? When we're talking about ankle mobility, we mean dorsiflexion. So this means how far can our knees track in front of our toes? And this certainly is very important for squatting. And CrossFit is relying on a lot of squats. So we have wall balls, we have squat cleans, we have squat snatches. A lot of things evolve around the squat. And the better our ability to bring our knees in front of our toes, the more upright our squat will be. And an upright, efficient squat pattern is way superior than a squat pattern that would look like more like leaned over, more like a powerlifting style squat pattern, for example. Basically, a more upright squat pattern lets us use more of the front of the leg, basically our quads, which helps with knee extension. Obviously, every athlete is different. We differ in body segment ratios, for example. This is the relationship of our bone segments to each other. Like, for example, how long are our shins, like our tibia, in relationship to our femurs, like our upper thigh bone. And those can influence squat movement patterns, but research shows not as much as ankle mobility. This is why we want to focus on ankle mobility and how to improve ankle mobility to have the most efficient squat and get the most out of our training actually. Now, what do we actually have to do to improve ankle mobility? And we would always categorize in two different styles. One of them would be short-term and one of them would be long-term improvements. As you know, warming up acutely, like in a short time frame, increases your mobility. So, what's that gonna do for us? If we work on our mobility, on our ankle mobility, on our dorsiflexion in the warm-up, this allows for a more upright squat pattern for every training session. And over time, this more upright squat pattern becomes more natural and the body will adapt and we will feel more confident, we will feel more stable and even stronger in this upright position with more dorsiflexion with improved ankle mobility. The other type I was talking about was more like long-term chronic effects. As I said earlier, stretching effects are very acute and sometimes for some structures they only last for 10 to 15 minutes. If we want to have substantial long-term effects on our ankle mobility, we need to invest, unfortunately, a lot of time. At this point, we would recommend 5 to 10 minutes of stretching every day, 3 times a day. As with everything, there's a plethora of movements you can do to prep any movement, basically. Sometimes you just want to experiment and we're going to do 3 different things that we believe are very helpful to improve ankle mobility on the short term. The first thing is mobilizing your ankle with the help of your hands. I have Jordi here, my friendly assistant, and he's going to mobilize his right ankle. His inside hand goes to his heel and his outside hand is going to the balls of his foot. And now he's basically bringing his toes towards his knees. Like he's applying like pulling pressure and then moving his ankle around. He can like hold in a tight spot and pull with his outer arm. He can like rotate and see for tight spots, hold it, do some contractions of the shin muscles to pull the toes actively to the knee and like look for positions to improve mobility in. As you can see, Jordi isn't wearing his shoes. And the reason for that is that shoes stabilizes our foot. They take away some of the pressure off your intrinsic foot musculature. They stabilize your foot, they put your knees and your heels in a much better position. And by taking off your shoes, the requirement for actual mobility, stability from the ankle increases quite a lot. That's why we like to warm up without our shoes. For our second exercise, Jordi is just sitting in a deep squat. The kettlebell is actually functioning as a counterbalance so that he can go as deep into the squat as possible, so like closing his knee angle, and stay as upright as possible, as we mentioned in the start. And now he's trying to actively pull his knees as far in front as possible and do some like rocking motions, like rocking back and forth, rocking from side to side, just to mobilize the ankle and get comfortable in the position. Also, now we're warming up all the little structures surrounding your ankle, since it's a very complex design joint. We always recommend doing this for several sets, maybe 2 to 3, for 20 to 40 seconds. For our last movement, you need a rubber band that you can find almost in every gym. And we're doing a banded distraction. The band is helping to pull his chin back as far as possible. So we're creating a bit more room in the ankle to allow the knee to come forward in front. And now Jordi is going to demonstrate how it looks like. Also, he's using the weight of his upper body and his arms to push his knee in front. And then he's doing the same thing as in the squat. He's doing some rocking motions, like rocking back and forth, rocking from side to side, maybe relaxing and going back into it. So really explore yourself and figure out what works best for you, where your ankles might feel tight, where you want to push, where you want to hold, where you want to contract and relax, especially like the anterior side of your shin. One last thing to help with long-term improvement of the ankle mobility would just be sitting in an air squat every day for a couple of minutes. This is one thing that could be accomplished very easily. You don't need any equipment for it. In the beginning, you could do the air squat with holding onto a table, supporting yourself behind yourself, and then from there just progress. In the beginning, this might be very uncomfortable, so we would recommend shorter bouts for multiple sets, and then you should try to progress yourself into longer air squat sittings, for example, 2 minutes, 3 minutes without pausing. Maybe building it up all the way to 5 or even 10 minutes to have really long-term effects and changes of the structure of your lower body, of your ankle, of your knee, of your hips.